10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Team Secrets turn to ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Team Secrets turn to pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Elder Titan.
Dire team pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
I'm doing great. It took us a while to get into things. The SEA finals. Oh.
Dire team pick.
You good? Awesome. Okay, yeah, so I'm really excited. We got best of threes finally, and unfortunately we did miss some of the earlier secret games, but had to finish up the grand finals of the SEA qualifiers, so understandable. But now we got the best of threes. We got Secret versus Team Spirit. And Secret, the last couple of games they've played have been very close, very tight. The last one, not so much maybe, but their game against Pro Dota, they came within a hair's breadth of losing, and it was incredible plays from both sides. Secret did take it in the end. That's why they're here. But not looking like the strongest team just yet. We'll have to see what they can do against Spirit. At least now they have two chances. If they lose the first game, they're not just out yet. But we'll have to see if they can do better in the best of threes than they've been feeling in the best of ones. I've been feeling a little bit nervous for them over the past few hours.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Beastmaster.
Dire team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Team Secrets turn to ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Hmm.
Dire team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. 10 seconds turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Okay.
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Chaul Warlord.
Team secrets turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Witch Doctor.
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Night Stalker.
Team secrets turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Dire team ban. 10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Team secrets turn to ban. Team secrets turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Naga All right. Siren. Oh, that's an Dire RT Zero. Team. Holy hell, this is going to be awesome here. Just make sure we have our mics unmuted in Dota TV. Again, I apologize for all the production issues thus far. I just switched over setups with Lyrical as he was doing the SEA region, so got to very quickly reset all my hotkeys at some point. I'm probably going to do that while the heroes are loading in. But we should get that taken care of as soon as possible. Team Spirit, last pick here. Remaining. They know they've got to get some sort of advantage thriving in the mid-game, because if you get Naga farmed up Reserve enough, time. Good God, that is a atrocious late-game to fight into.
Yeah, and I actually really like the combo of the Pugna with the Naga Siren, because you have early game secured with the Pugna and late game secured with the Naga. The idea is going to be Pugna groups up with the rest of his team, pushes towers early to make space for the Naga to farm up that Radiance. And then in the stage of the game where Pugna starts falling off, Naga takes over. So Team Secret are going for a kind of draft where there isn't really any weak stage of their game. And a Mirana last pick for Spirit.
Is that Min Mirana?
It looks like it, yeah. So they're going to try and crap on the Pugna, which they definitely can do. If they land an arrow, you get a double Starfall. That hero's almost dead. And Mirana has the range advantage on a Pugna, at least with the right clicks. So we'll have to see how this goes.
All right, I think my hotkeys are relatively sorted there, trying to punch them in as fast as possible. So yeah, I'm liking Team Spirit, but it is a flimsy, very late game. Draft. I mean, Troll Warlord, he can scale so well, so can Funic on the Night Stalker, but it's still risky to let yourself go too late up against a Naga, so they're going to have to put pressure on the Naga early. But then again, that means Eternal Envy might not face as much pressure in the mid, and he's going to secure some lane advantage, so I'm liking what Team Secret are putting out, but we can't tap out Team Spirit whatsoever. They have looked like incredible contenders all throughout these open quals.
Yeah, and there is a lot of roam potential onto Eternal Envy in the mid lane here with Avenge with the Night Stalker. Look to see that first nighttime show up and them to smoke and look for the kill. They need to shut down this secret draft before the Naga has a chance to come online. If they can take towers, and I've got to restart because my map isn't letting me click on things again, so 1 second. I'll be
right back.
Oh, that's
a fun spectator bug. While you're doing that, we can go ahead and quickly introduce the teams before the blood starts flowing, which no doubt it will ASAP. We've got very aggressive heroes here. It's going to be Puppy playing as Elder Titan. He's played that fantastically so far. Our TZ is going to be on the Naga Siren. Over here, we are going to have Eternal Envy on that mid Pugna up here near the river. It's going to be Bulba on the offlane Beastmaster. And finally, Pylai Dai sitting on the support Witch Doctor. We've seen some crazy death wards out from him in the open calls, so definitely can't tap him out, even though he's squishy. Over here on the side of Team Spirit, we've got Ghostick going to be on that offlane Slardar. Lots of regen bought up for him. Over here, we are going to have Undershock on the mid Mirana. Go Black smoking up there on the Vengeful Spirit. It's going to be Funic on the Night Stalker walking around there, and Havost on the Carry Troll Warlord. I am so excited to see this get underway. Lots of comfort heroes for both teams, but it's all going to come down to this. This is a best of three series, so first one to take two games will advance to the grand finals of the TI6 Open Qualifiers.
Yes, they certainly will. And I am back now. I can click on heroes. Everything is Gucci.
Oh, good.
Just in time to get into the action. Looks like we may have a clash around this bottom rune.
Yeah, everyone's going in here. We got fun of filling up the void here. There's gonna be an arrow. We'll connect to the pilot eye. The squishiest here, the easiest one to get. There's gonna be a crush. We'll connect to the puppy. They're looking for something here. They get the crap onto pilot eye. Looks like he will be alive for now, but may end up falling. There's a nice cast bounce between three, and the first blood goes the way of Undershot, taking out the witch doctor. Now Funnick actually stuck. If he'd taken one more shot, he's gonna be down to 25 HP. But he's gonna be spirit from Puppy plucking him off from downtown, and that's gonna be nice. Elder Titan turning things around. So in the end, they do sacrifice one for one supports, not detrimental, but the first blood advantage is always going to be super, super yummy there for Spirit.
Yeah, and they even it up at least, so it won't just be a one-for-one advantage. Arteezy should have a pretty decent lane down here as well. They're running Puppy and Pilot Eye right now to try and zone out Ghostick, and it looks like they should be fairly successful. Otter's got to be really cautious of the Puppy right-click with the minus armor.
Oh,
that
the
Arteezy
cast is
can
coming
provide.
Through. Puppy, he has that spirit. He doesn't have the stomp there, and Toby was explaining to me the little bug going on. If you have the stomp picked up before the spirit and you get close range and cast it off, you'll get a double stack of damage between the physical and magical, so it actually does a huge portion of damage level 1, but picking up the spirit first did allow him to get that snipe here near the rune, so definitely worthwhile.
Yeah, and we haven't mentioned it yet, but Bulba did go for that level 1 Iron Talon, so it looks like he will be full-time jungling, not wanting to risk going up against Havoc's troll, not to mention Gallblack. They've got a nice stun set up there, so is at least some kill potential on the Bulba. He could potentially get some farm in lane, but he wants to just maximize his own and is going to trade that for any pressure onto Havoc. So you're giving a troll free farm in lane, that's not ideal, but Bulba, he's going to find a lot out of this jungle. We've seen it over and over again. He gets those early necro books up, has a huge impact on the game, and we'll have to see when he chooses to rotate out. I expect it'll be with that first roar.
Yeah, I mean, he's going to need to find something quick here. Like you mentioned, leaving that troll all the way alone is a huge mistake. Havoc making so much out of the lane already, already picking up 12 last hits. He's having a very fun time here, and he's not even being supported up that much. I mean, Ventral Spirit going through, stacking up for him, but he doesn't need babysitting. He doesn't really need anything. So as soon as Beastmaster hits that 6, he's going to need to rotate, and Secret's going to need to find kills because their draft depends on them having successful lanes.
Yeah, and so far, Eternal Envy is doing very well mid. 11-2 versus the 5-3 of Undershock, so he's playing this lane well already with that early null, doing a lot of damage surprisingly, and his attack animation a little bit better than Morana, I think. Not that I'm super familiar with this matchup, but
I mean, they're both just kind of sitting there, like laying back, slowly winding up, tossing things out. So neither is ideal. But now we are going to have Eternal Envy here, putting those 2 points in Nether Blast. So he definitely wants to get some push early, wants to be able to zone early. And he does get that T-Crep onto Undershock. And
Ghostick. Ghostick looking for a kill potentially in the jungle. Bulba's getting low, and Ghostick spotting him out. With a crush, he may actually be able to get this kill if Bulba takes any more damage.
Yeah, I mean, he's definitely looking for something. He just does have to sprint in and crush. He doesn't have any tools yet. No force, no blink, obviously, at 3 minutes in the game. But Bulba has to be very, very careful here. There is going to be the crush. They do get it off. Does he have the raw damage, though? Bulba looking to turn. He's limping away. There is still the sprint
slow,
on cooldown.
I think it's
oh,
enough.
Man. It is going to be enough here. They don't have a bash there. And that's going to be Pilot Eye TPing in. Oh, Eternal Envy so low. Gets down to the Mirana mid lane. There's going to be a crush here onto Pilot Eye. Ghostick slithering away. Now he's slowed up again by the boars. Bulba limping back after him. Puppy comes through. There's going to be a stomp. The arrow eaten by a boar, so won't connect with Pilot Eye. And it looks like Bulba will end up living through this engage. They trade for the Slardar. Ash just went so south for Spirit. They got greedy. They wanted early rotations, but they didn't pack the damage and they didn't show any respect for the Pilot Eye rotation in.
Still. Probably as the Night Stalker goes down elsewhere. Oh, just kills himself to a neutral, never mind. But yeah, Eternal Envy going down basically solo to the Mirana. That makes it kind of worth it. And Puppy did have to rotate from bottom. Secret did have to bring in a lot of heroes to counter the gank of the Slardar. So even though he doesn't get the kill, still a lot of time wasted.
Undershock.
He could be down again. Undershock.
Yeah, he's going in. He's dropping that Starstorm. It's already level 3 and just plunking him down with that extra proc, and that's going to be Undershock getting a kill without even having to go through the bother of a right click, and now she's going to be flying in some boots for herself. Nice and speedy. Getting that kitty cat some movement speed. And over here, Ghostick, he's going to go through. He's going to pick up this Bounty Rune pretty much uncontested. So in terms of kills, Team Spirit are looking very good. The rotations have been on point aside from Ghostick maybe getting a little bit ambitious from that Slardar.
And it was a touch greedy from Bulba to keep farming in that position without going back to base to regen. He was still low and they knew he was in the area. Undershock assumed that he would stick around, and as a result, once again he's low, there's the chance for the kill and they find it.
Absolutely. Now over here there will be a rotation in from a smoked up Night Stalker, and that's pretty spooky there at the first night time. They're looking for something here, but Puppy, he's around Mirana. She's got the arrow if she wants to scout something out.
And she's hasted as well. This could be a great kill opportunity, but Eternal Envy drops the ward in the trees, should be playing fairly safe.
He's gonna go through. He decreps Mirana. He's gonna zap her once with that ward, but looks like Funnic going back on through. He's gonna zap down there. Funnic, no respect for the ward, gets completely plunked. A puppy stomp, very well placed ward right there. Eternal Envy placing it just so far back that Nightstalker couldn't go through and give aggro to the ward before he gave aggro to the Pugnas. So that's gonna be another kill and Team Secret tying up.
Yeah, and Puppy's Elder Titan. I mean, it shouldn't be a surprise at this point. We've seen it do well so many games now, but he is so on point with this hero, making so much space, always seems to be in the right spot at the right time. Amazing play from him.
Absolutely. Now, up top, once again, Troll Warlord still farming up 50 last hits at 5 minutes in. He has gotten every little chunk of CS that he really, really wants. And now Havost, he's already sitting for the makings of what looks to be either an armlet or a helm, depending on how he wants to go. And I mean, that's kind of spooky here. When does Secret start having to rotate on the offensive?
They're gonna pressure with tower pressure once the Pugna gets his levels up. He's gonna wait for that 4 points in Nether Blast, I imagine. And then they gather together as four, go for some towers. But I imagine they're not really gonna be looking to roam for ganks specifically. I imagine it'll be more counter-initiating, so they'll pressure towers, wait for Team Secret to come to them.
At a little bit of a pause here, so we can talk about the overall momentum here. So once again, Troll just dominating up with these last hits, but Arteezy not too far behind. He has found a fair amount of spaces. There's no real offlaner here. Slaughter's been spending most of his time rotating to mid, looking for those crushes, and well, he's found himself some Tranquil Boots, but we'll talk about what Arteezy's picking up here. He's already got himself the Arcane Boots, so definitely prioritizing that early mana, and that means he's most likely at some point going to disassemble into Octarine Core, but for now, definitely enjoying that spammability of the Mirror Image and the Riptide.
Absolutely. It's a build that he does favor, just for that exact reason. And as far as momentum and timings go, Bulba, he's getting very close to that level 6. So once he's got it, they can easily rotate to gank a lane. I imagine Undershock would be the primary choice. Potentially, they go top for Havost. Early on, he is fairly squishy, 900 HP. He's managed to find his Helm of Dom, though, so he's not really going to ever be low. And already looking to apply some early pressure onto this tower.
I mean, why not? He's got a couple points there in that little fervor, so he's going through, smacking fast. He's taking some tower shots, so he has to de-aggro eventually, but, you know, he's still completely uncontested. Beastmaster has picked up his 6, so maybe looking to shout, but they need some raw damage here. And where's the damage coming from on Secret? Right now, a big chunk of it is going to be on Eternal Envy, as Arteezy just needs a couple more items to really come online.
Together, Puppy and Bulba should be able to do the job.
Oh, swap back. Looks like Arteezy gonna get punished here. Maybe he goes back on through. There's gonna be a magic missile to secure the kill. They do have that Malik connecting onto two, but the Moonlight Shadow stops the initiation from there, and that's gonna be dead Arteezy. Definitely not a time you want to let him drop. He's so crucial to farm up in these early levels.
Mid, Eternal Envy taking a double Starfall, and he does get turned around.
Oh, life drain. Yeah, I mean, that's gonna keep him super healthy. It's like Death Prophet's Spirit Siphon on, like, absolute PCP. It is so aggressive, and so you're basically not going to walk into Eternal Envy. And we did talk about how Team Spirit picked themselves up 3 beefy melee cores, and Eternal Envy can punish that. The problem is, you know, if Life Drain's ever not on cooldown, or it's not enough, or you're just getting slapped down too hard, then you lose your Pugna, and you lose most of your damage pre-25 minutes.
Yeah, and before he gets his Aghanim Scepter, the Drain has a decent cooldown. So if he gets bashed by Havost in the middle of casting it, then he doesn't have it to fall back on, at least early on.
All right, I think we're getting word that your in-game mic is not coming through, so just make sure your settings are checked on that. Sometimes you have to go through, like, check Steam devices. It gets fussy.
Okay.
Hopefully we can get that fixed right away. Now, there is going to be a smoke up from Team Secret looking to pick off something here. Goldblack popping out a nice Observer Ward, but will not scout out the smoke rotation. Now, they might be going in onto Havost, but Havost backing off, playing this one safe.
Okay, just testing my mic, and it sounds like it should be working.
All right, hopefully it does. Now the smoke will be revealed. Puppy, he's going to be sitting there in those trees. They know something's up. It looks like Team Spirit are willing to sacrifice this tower. They don't want to lose too much too soon, as it's really important they don't give Team Secret too much of an advantage early.
Sorry, just AFK trying to make sure this is working. So it looks like the tower top will fall. Bulba taking advantage of that, as Havost had rotated out into the jungle.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. I mean, Havos right now, all he needs to do is get his farm. All he needs to do is turn into that big raid boss, like, you don't run at me, I run at you kind of hero. And so far, he's doing a good job here. He's getting his levels. He's already level 8, already has the completed helm, and about 700 gold on top of that and the Wraith Band. So what's his next pick here? Does he look for those tier 2 boots? Does he look for, you know, some sort of... Oh, stomp mid, Undershock. He's going to get maladed up. Will get swapped back. The life drain going to get canceled here. Gold Black may give his life for this, but keeping the Cormorana alive. In fact, can they chase this deep enough? There's going to be one final Nether Blast. They will get the kill. Eternal Envy. He's now going to be 1, 1, and 2. And there's going to be serious pressure onto the tower. Going to be blasted down. Level 4 Nether Blast doing so much work. So that's going to be probably a tier mid tower. And that's okay. They're going to go for the Fortify. They may have to back off here.
Nah, they've committed. The Bulb is here now, and they'll take it down fairly easily. Eternal Envy, as far as what he picks up next, I would really love to see an Aether Lens. Since the hero is so squishy, he needs to be able to sit as far back as possible, and Aether Lens provides him the ability to cast out those Nether Blasts from a bit of a safer range.
Yeah, I mean, that may be a priority pick here for Eternal Envy. He's already having some mana problems, so just the casual int stats on that are going to be great as well.
And the other thing I'd like to point out as well is that Arteezy, he did die in that bot lane earlier because he did not level Song of the Siren. He's now level 7, still has not got it. So going for the greedy build here, and that could punish him if they go for more gank rotations, as they have brought a couple heroes down to this bot lane.
You know, I think Arteezy can get away with it. He's pretty slippery in general. He's got that decent movement speed with those tier 2 boots. So, yeah, if they rotate another 3-4 heroes, maybe they can get him down again. But that's already so costly, and that will already allow Secret to push out other lanes of the map. So Arteezy just has to play safe, which he's had some troubles with so far this calls, but hasn't cost him too dearly just yet.
Yeah, he's on Onaga this time. He'll be aware of how he needs to play. And the fact that Secret have already taken down two tier 1 towers that are able to push out the lanes, that makes it a lot easier for Arteezy to detect when rotations are coming. But speaking of rotations, it's now the Dire into the Roche Pit.
Absolutely.
Take it very quickly.
I mean, God have post on the Troll Warlord. He's hitting with 2 points in Fervor. He's got that Helm of the Dominator, so there's more than enough lifesteal. But there's going to be an Earth Splitter coming back under the pit. Puppy wants something, but everyone's going to get out safely. Looks like the arrow will come through. I don't think it connects. Oh, just barely grazes on Pilot Eye's shoulder. And he's going to get zapped down. There's no way he can get out of this. There's going to be a shout here. Swap back. Ghost Stick's still alive. They're going to look for more Nether Blast, getting everyone below. There's going to be that ward coming back on through. Another stomp from Puppy will secure Havos sitting back into the fight. Undershock, he's going to have to dive really deep in this one if he wants it. Looks like the arrow will go through, will not connect onto anyone. Courier was sitting near the mid tower that whole time, so what looked like a super bloody engage results in Team Spirit taking a net gain there. They do end up getting the Aegis onto the Mirana, and then they only drop one hero on Secret. So it was a win for Team Spirit, but not by a huge, huge margin.
Yeah, and sure, they get the Aegis, which is great. Secret could have lost that a lot worse, though. The fact that they were able to disengage so cleanly, only losing Pylai die, that's completely acceptable for them to not lose more. And I mean, against this lineup, you've got Avenge, you've got a Slardar, and you've got the Troll Warlord. It is inevitable that you will lose Aegis this game. It's just going to happen. So on the whole, I don't think Secret are too concerned.
All right, so down bottom there is going to be a little bit of a pressure here, just cutting the wave there with Undershock, who is farming up a fair amount of gold. Now, are we going to see another Stepping Stone or straight to Axe? Oh, Eternal Envy, you are just way, way far in. He goes in with the D-crap, he's trying to TP up, but just gets arrowed, gets smacked down, and Havost secures his first kill of the game.
I mean, that's going to happen when you're a Pugna pushing tier 2s by yourself. Maybe just a little bit greedy as far as positioning goes for him there, but... still, he pulls them all up to top lane. This is still part of the game plan. Remember, Arteezy is being given space by these movements. And even if you lose a hero or two, it's still part of the overall plan.
Oh, Shout will cancel the TP of Funnic. He's going to go through the Naga Siren, getting the last hit for that. So Arteezy finally picking up some blood, putting her at 1, 1, and 1 for a kill score. That's going to look really nice. It's only a Night Stalker, but almost a 550 gold change for that. Almost 1,000 gold XP, or rather 1,000 XP swing.
Yeah, and Arteezy getting very close to that relic money. Only needs but 900. With this tower, that gets even closer. So he's on for a fantastic Radiance timing.
Now, Fortify popped out down here. It doesn't look like there's any rotations in from the Dire, so Team Spirit, they've got to let this one fall, and that means they lose a little bit of advantage over the Roche Pit. All their tier 1s are down, and they've really got to start making up some ground here, because Team Secret's lineup thrives on map control. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Yeah, to fix your mic problem here, just be on this behind the scenes. Go to audio, configure Steam devices, unplug, replug, and then search for the mic again. It happens sometimes. You have to go into Steam to do it manually. It's super dumb, so thanks, Reborn. Hopefully we'll fix that Dota TV audio as soon as possible. We're trying our best here. Production issues are our specialty here at Beyond the Summit.
Shots fired on yourself, I guess.
I guess so, man. I'm trying. And now over here, we are going to have our TZ once again farming up. Has a big chunk of pennies. Looks to just be waiting to right-click that Radiant straight out. Has enough for the Relic if he wants to go dip in and buy it after this wave. And now, it's pretty early on here. It's only 14 minutes, but looking at the overall net worth, Troll is starting to skyrocket. And Troll Warlord really wasn't checked in the laning phase. We talked about him having a free lane up against the Beastmaster, and he secured himself a kill, a couple assists, and now taking an Ancient stack, he's already going to be finding himself the Sanj and Yasha. He's farming up very quickly, and Havost, obviously, he scales fantastically on almost any hero, Troll especially. I'm interested to see how Naga and Troll are going to match up and what their power peaks are going to be, when they're going to shift momentum, who's going to be in charge of who, because for right now it seems like Spirit, they're feeling comfortable with their ability to kill, but Secret are feeling very comfortable with their ability to push and de-push and get towers.
Okay, I've tried reconnecting my microphone, so guys, if this hasn't worked, please let me know in chat, but for now we'll just go along with what we've got and hope that it worked. I'm really not used to dealing with these issues. Don't often cast in lobbies.
Ooh,
so
smoke coming up here. Teams, Spirit actually looking for some very big aggression here. They got the blink on the Slaughter, looking to debut that. They're gonna go through. They don't land the crush onto anyone. There's gonna be the Troll coming up with a lot of damage. It's gonna be the Beastmaster shouting it off the Ghost. There's a swap back. Goldplack trying to keep his heroes alive. Bulba actually getting very, very low to the Starstorm. It looks like Undershock may end up getting killed here. It looks like, oh, Troll Warlord goes through, gets the kill onto Puppy, and they're gonna be a swap in. Maledict plopping out. Not gonna do enough. Three dead on Secret. Morana may end up ticking down here. She's getting very, very low. Can she heal up, or will the Maledict be enough? She is going to go down, pop in the Aegis, but will be technically no death for Team Spirit, or one if you count the Aegis, but Team Secret dropping a lot there. The bright side is that Arteezy doesn't go down, Pugna doesn't go down, so they drop supports and offlaner, or support the jungler, however you look at it, but it's still going to be over 1,000 gold swing for Team Spirit. XP almost 2,200. Looking at the overall gold chart, that's a big, big plummet in favor of Team Spirit.
But the Arteezy Radiance is here now. 16 and a half minutes in, a great timing for him considering his one death. And you do have to be a little bit worried about how big Havost is getting. He's 9k on the network chart, but now with Naga picking up this item, the cancer begins. And Team Spirit, even though they have done very well in this early game, I don't think they're going to be super confident with their game position just because of how uncontested Arteezy's been.
Now, speaking of Arteezy, we pick up that Fire Sword here, so his push potential just goes through the roof, and combine that with a Pugnet now with the Veil, like you mentioned, there's a lot of push potential, there's a lot of kill potential, but Team Spirit, I mean, they've got a couple natural BKB builders, so that could very much benefit them pretty soon.
Absolutely. And I wouldn't be surprised to see that next item from Havost. It's just so key on the hero to let him get in and do his damage. But the tier 2 pushes are coming now.
Arrow eaten by Puppy just barely grazes him in the back of the face. And that's going to be, well, at least Team Spirit getting some eyes on where Team Secret are, but they aren't able to counter-initiate just yet. They want to go in for something. You can tell Havost is itching for the blood, but he's going to have to back off and play safe. And for now, he's feeling all right there. He's got his loyal Puppy by his side, which, you know, Puppy, the Alpha Wolf,
boo.
Not Puppy the hero. Sorry.
Boo.
I didn't mean to trigger anyone. I'm so sorry. Oh, no.
The other thing to mention here is that Funnik has now picked up a very early Aghanim Scepter on his Night Stalker. 17 minutes in, this is going to be huge for Team Spirit's vision game. And they need that, as their map is now starting to look quite dark with those two tier 2s down already at the 17-minute mark. They need as much vision advantage as possible, and that'll help out a lot. The Beastmaster hasn't picked up a gem yet, so that's not really going to be a big deal for Secret just at the moment, but it's going to become a problem as this game goes later.
Yeah, I think there's probably about another 5-10 minutes where Secret have to push in as aggressively as possible. I mean, again, with that Nether Blast, with the Naga Siren being able to farm up multiple lanes at once, they've really got to go in and exert their dominance now, or, like you mentioned, that big fat Havos is going to start to be an issue. Now, big smoke up top here. They're looking for something. Once again, they've got that, but Naga not joining the party, and there is going to be a slither away from Ghoststick. Moonlight Shadow coming out. Do they have detection here? They're looking for something, but Goldblack, he's going to be invisible. The Earth Splitter will end up going through. They get the pick with the Necronomicons, and that's going to be some cute Sentry Vision coming out from Bulba with those Necrotoos. All right, it's going to be Team Spirit looking to maybe re-engage here. Funnik gets that negative earn on himself and will be scattering back. There's going to be the Veil popped out. Arrow coming through from the Mirana, but will not connect onto anyone. Eternal Envy sitting there, guarding that Nether Ward, sitting in the bushes, and it's going to do a fair amount of damage to Havos, but he's going to heal it right back up.
And the Venge going down, not the biggest of deals from Team Spirit, but this does give Secret an opportunity to push into the tower potentially, although it may be a trap.
Oh,
Team Spirit.
Nice crush. Will connect just on the Pylite dive, but at least getting some serious zoning potential. Pylite gets plunked down from that Marana with the Ags, but now Arteezy here to save the day. He's singing, he's slithering, and then looking for something here. They go back in, the mirror image comes out. There's going to be a leap away. Funnick getting zapped down by that Nether Ward coming through. Now Hobos, oh, he's hungry. He wants something. Puppy gets the stun, and that looks like Eternal Envy. Going to be draining him down. They bring back in Puppy. He's going to get swapped back. He's going to get killed off. Oh, this is looking detrimental here. EE trying to do something in terms of zoning, but Havos, he's fast. He's chasing after you with those phase boots. EE, can you run fast enough? I'm not quite sure. It looks like he's going to get crushed in. Ghoststick wrapping around, and the T-Crep can't save him forever. Slardar goes through and gets the pick. So Secret getting pummeled here. Arteezy did what he could with the song and the reinitiate, but they end up losing a bunch.
And that was a really odd decision from Secret. They could have just used the song to completely disengage. They would have all been able to get out. Arteezy had the boots of travel, but instead they try and awkwardly take the fight when they're already one hero down. And they should know at this point that Team Spirit have the better 5-on-5 team fight. So I'm a little confused why they chose to take that. They are not pressured to take fights right now. They can just disengage, spread the map, and push in when they have the numbers advantage. But instead they choose to take a fight 4v5 and it costs them.
Absolutely. I mean, looking at the overall gold, it's actually starting to look kind of spooky for Secret. 5,000 advantage for Spirit at 20 minutes in. And I mean, earlier in the qualifiers, we were talking about 20,000 leads like they were no big deal. But this is actually pretty big. Spirit, they're a team that knows how to capitalize on little mistakes, little disadvantages. And moving forward, when you have a troll that's this farmed up, he's sitting at the top of the net worth chart, that's trouble. I don't know if Arteezy can get big enough on the Naga fast enough. And now Scan will reveal Team Spirit, so at least Radiant have eyes on the situation.
It's a hard to go for this Roche right now, though. Team Spirit take it very quickly, and if Secret engage wrong, then they can easily be punished by this.
All right, we have a 5-minute delay on the stream, but apparently your mic is now working in Dota TV, so yay.
Oh, thank goodness. Sorry about that, guys. I'm glad I finally managed to fix it.
Oh, there's a Moonlight Shadow here. They're looking for the jump. They've got that blink out to Golbat now. Oh, Funnick, he's going through. Envy is in some serious trouble. Can he land the decrep? But nice song from Arteezy. He's singing. He's saving the day, getting the stun out to 3. There's going to be an arrow here. It won't connect onto anyone. Earth Splitter coming out. They do have the stun to lock everyone in place, but oh, they run away. Oh, there's a swap back bench. Putting in the hours. Funnick will get zapped down in the end. The Gem of True Sight is on the floor. Bubble getting zapped up by Goldblack, because Decrep, they're looking for something here. Puppy just going in, chasing him down. Does he have a stomp? He does, but the animation is a little bit long. Now Goldblack getting slowed up, will get plopped down by the Nether Blast. EE, what looked like was certain death, is now turning into a bunch of kills going in favor of Secret. In the end, Ghoststick slithering off, trying to TP out. The Puppy TP's in. They're not going to be able to go through. The stomp going to be slightly too late.
Nice attempt.
That's going to be Secret showing some signs of life here. They're not just going to get rolled over that easily. They can fight.
They do protect the Roshan. They don't let Team Spirit get it. They can potentially go for it themselves now. They don't have the best lineup for it, unfortunately, but at least they can potentially get some vision up around the pit, and it is going to be key to stopping the close from getting
a chance. Speaking of which, just drained down. He can't even run. He can't hide. Eternal Envy. No mercy. Good golly. That was a Veil Life Drain combined with Puppy's Stomp.
That was also 3 points in natural order on top of a Veil. You cannot underestimate that magical damage. And Havost at this point needs a BKB so badly. But his deaths are limiting his ability to get it.
It's looking pretty even here. I mean, looking at the overall gold, it's actually been turned around to about a 2,000 lead for Spirit, which at this point is nothing. In fact, if Naga continues to get the farm she's getting, they can very much take this into the late game. The problem is, can Havost man up? Is he going to do it? Now, there's going to be a cask long range, and they are going to go through. They get the stomp at the Funnick. Can he flap away fast enough? It's nighttime, so he's speedy, but they're bringing in the whole crew. He's going to go through. He's going to get deep trapped. He's going to get drained down. There's going to be the urn coming back out, and oh, he's netted in place. Goodbye, Funnick. He'll have to live to see another day, and that's going to be Nightstalker's sixth death.
I mean, him losing, he's already got his key items, he's got that ag, so him dying isn't the biggest of deals, other than the fact that it feeds Secret money, but with him down, that actually does give them the vision advantage, which makes them feel safe to go into the Roche. And with the Envy, or with the Arteezy illusions pushing in both mid and bottom, there's no way that Team Spirit can get out here without it being very, very obvious to Secret.
All right, so this Roshan not melting as fast as if the Dire were taking it, but it's still going down, tried and true. I believe Team Spirit are scanning the Roche pit, which doesn't work, but you know, maybe seeing if there's eyes, if anyone's standing on the cliff right around the pit, that will give you vision. So Team Spirit, they kind of sense something's going on, but they aren't able to go through and stop it. It's just going to be a little bit of free farm around the map. Meanwhile, Arteezy's been using these illusions to the best of his ability, disassembles the arcane boots, picks up the boots of travels, and is going to be building into the Octarine very soon.
Yeah, and I mean, the game is not over. It's only 24 minutes in. It's 11-12, the gold lead exactly even, but it really does feel like Team Spirit have missed their window now. Arteezy, the most farmed hero on the map, he's almost got that Octarine, only 700 gold, and they don't have great tools to deal with him. They have no stuns that go through BKB, he has the way to disengage with the Song, he's got the Aegis, and Havost doesn't have quite enough damage to deal with him when there's anyone else nearby, so it's not like they can just burst him down. Things get hard now for Team Spirit, and they've got to take pickoffs, they've got to take engagements.
Bulba.
But yeah, Bulba with the vision. He's providing so much to Secret right now, allowing them to dodge the fights except for the ones they actually want to take.
Yeah, now there is going to be a troll popping out. He wants to do some troll things, so they're going to have to trade for a tier 1, but looks like this could get bloody right here. They're going to be bringing in everyone. The Stomp's going to get through. They get the Spirit scouting out onto the high ground. Now Funic, he's going to be Moonlight Shadowed up, but there's going to be a Stomp winding up, connecting with the two. It looks like Ghost is getting very, very low, in fact. May just have to sit back and slither on back to base.
Now, with the Necro Books and the Blast from the low ground, Secret conceived so safely.
Did you see the Night Stalker getting plummeted down?
Yeah.
And that's going to be
killed the Necro Book and took the Pugna Blast.
Yeah, that's
not
that's
ideal.
A lot of damage. And that's underneath his own racks. And now just Arteezy's little illusions putting in the hours. Getting down there. Some more Necro Blast coming in there. It's going to be the Troll coming down. Eternal Ending being pummeled.
Again.
Oh, nice song from Arteezy. He's singing once again, saving the day. This Naga putting in some work. And Funic, he's chasing him down looking for something. It's nighttime. But can he find anything out of this? It's going to be a Veil here. Funic getting blasted down by the Netherboard. This Pugna pick is paying off in the best way. Havost, he's going to go through the BKB, but he still gets shouted up. There's going to be the Netherboard coming, or rather the Deathboard coming back on through. Goldblack has palmed it down, and Havost, he's just going to be sprinting back to his own base, playing in such a defensive position. Not where you expected to see Havost here on a Troll Warlord. These racks are exposed. They're under siege. Arteezy laying in the damage with that completed Octarine core. It's looking good for Secret now in terms of gold. They brought it home to a 2,500 gold experience lead. Oh, crush in onto Eternal Envy. They get the net though. Can they turn us onto Ghostick? Arteezy is burning down. Nice Mirana Ag, so EE trying to drain himself back up. There's going to be an arrow. Will connect onto Bulba. And looks like Havost is able to go through. Get the kill onto Pugna. They'll give it a double kill onto the Beastmaster. Now Puppy stunned up, bashed up. He's going to go down. It's a triple kill for Havost. We can't count this guy out ever. Undershock doing a lot of work there with the Ag Starstorm. But the real hero there is the Troll Warlord bringing in the damage. He had to pop that BKB charge to run away, which means it's not going to be up for a little bit now. But only a good while, a good usage of it, as he didn't have to buy back into the fight from dying.
Yeah, and Undershock with the double Starstorm on the Pugna, such a good play. When he's decrept himself, he takes extra damage from that, obviously, and that was maybe Secret overstaying their welcome a little bit. It really does feel like when the Song is on cooldown, they have to play so much more carefully. You see there how fast Eternal Envy goes down without that Song to protect him. So they don't really need to overcommit for that because they do have the Naga. They're comfortable taking this late, but they thought they could get a little bit more. They do still take the ranged racks, but a bit of a costly engagement. Still, Arteezy gets out, so it's not going to be really that big of an issue for them.
No, not quite. Now we look at the builds coming out. Beastmaster picking up that Staff of Wizardry. So what are we looking at here? Are we going to go for four staffs or yules or dagons or what?
A four staff would be really nice to potentially save his Pugna. Whenever Havost goes on someone, you can force staff him away. You can try and kite the troll a little bit. And I imagine that's the plan. Alternatively, it could be an Ags as a way of dealing with Havost's BKB, but I think the regular roar is just fine.
So.
Yeah. Yeah. Normally you'd start with the point booster. So my guess is it will be the four step.
Now, we haven't talked a whole lot about the Vengeful Spirit here, but those swaps have been completely clutch. The problem is, once you swap someone out, you can't really do much more. I mean, you just gotta let them either run back to base or die anyway. So even though Venge has been playing her little heart out, it may not be enough to save her whole team.
Yeah, and honestly, in this scenario, Goldblack would really rather be using those swaps offensively. You can get Eternal Envy out of position in the middle of your base and chunk him down before he can react, then you're in great shape. But like you say, they've got to keep using it defensively when Havost gets caught out by the Song, and then there's no follow-up after that.
Speaking of song, we've got Arteezy postured up to go for something here. He's applying some push, just the illusions, posing a problem for Undershock already. Now Marana, I mean, she's got herself the makings of what looks to be a BKB if they need it. Now there is going to be the Aegis consumed here, so Iggy has to play careful. Oh, he's going to get jumped on here, pounded down. He's out of the fight for a minute. No buyback on him. The song comes a little too late for Arteezy. Looks for the kill onto Havoc. The arrow comes in. It won't connect. The Earth Splitter comes out. Looks for Havoc. Football fishing with that. We'll get stomped. We'll get stuck back in. Now Goldblatt goes through with the swap, trying to save him. Pylite Eye. He's running away. He's getting smashed up by the Night Stalker. Undershot with the Moonlight. Okay. It's going to be some serious damage coming out here. It's Puppy trying to run away. They get the Night Stalker kill in the back line. Now Puppy looking for the stomp. It's not going to connect to anyone. It's okay. Arteezy with the Naga Illusion securing a kill there onto the Marana. Looking more here onto Goldblatt, but may not be enough. Oh my god. Naga Siren. Please relax. Getting a kill on Venge under her tier 4s with an illusion with a fraction of health. Now this is going to be most likely a Rax as the Necro units are popped down. There's only so much Ghosta can do. Popping that amplified damage onto Arteezy, but there's no follow-up.
Riptide damage combined with the Natural Order Spirit.
It's freaking strong. Oh my god.
And the range of damage that Secret can pump out with that combo is ridiculous. And it's only going to get worse. Arteezy, not even close to six slotted yet. He only gets stronger from here, and Team Spirit already a lane down. This is looking very good for your Radiant side.
Yeah, I mean, in terms of net worth, it's actually not too much of a huge lead, just because the kill score is relatively even, slightly
doesn't in matter.
Spirit's favor. But yeah, I mean, the racks are going to start adding up, and in terms of XP, it's looking very good for Spirit. Again, just because they've had the Naga go and soaking up that XP all to herself with the rest of her team fights.
Yeah, and at this point, Team Spirit, they're running out of options. They've got to try and move out of the base and find some good picks. It's what their lineup's built for. They are really good at ganking, but with the Naga constantly pushing the lanes in, it's hard for them to make that play. Even with the vision advantage provided by the Night Stalker, anytime your lanes are pushed in, it is incredibly obvious to Secret whenever Team Spirit are going for a play. If they smoke up, the lane pushes in, and it's really obvious they're not there.
Okay, now we're going to have a rotation in. It's going to be Funnick walking around. Again, it is nighttime, so he's got that big old vision going his way, and he's got the Ags, but the gem has been dropped a while back, shortly after he picked it up. In fact, now Arteezy. Oh, he's hunting here. He wants something. The arrow comes in. We'll just take out a Thunderhide. Not going to be doing anything. Well, the TP is scouted out, but they can't do much to break it for now. So it's just going to be Radiant asserting the dominance. Oh, they go for the shout here. Funnick just going to get drained dry. No mana, no health. Goodbye, Night Stalker. A minute without anything there. No voids, no crippling fears, no nothing.
Yeah, I am still really enjoying this combination of the Spirit with Eternal Envy's damage. It's redonk.
Oh, Ghost there's going to be a blink in at the BKB of Marana, but nice save from Arteezy. Looking for more here. Going to be a leap away. Eternal Envy goes in with the Decrypt. They get the net here onto Ghostic. He's stunned in place. Even the BKB can't hold him back from that. Now he's going to get swapped back there. They're looking for something here. They got the Earth Splitter coming up from Puppy. Oh, Puppy ripping apart the Vengeful Spirit. Oh, Havoc. No mercy on him. He's BKB'd up. He wants to go for something. We're going to be taking a full duration death ward right to the base. He's netted in place. It's going to be a dead Havoc. He has the immediate buyback. We'll plop it down.
But no BKB.
This is looking really, really good for Secret. They're going back on through. They've got Puppy once again. No mercy. The Spirit onto the high ground, getting some vision. It's Team Spirit trying to figure out what to do. They've got the Troll Warlord back in the fight. They bring their damage, but there's like so little survivability up against the raw burst coming out of Secret right now.
Yeah, and with the net of Arteezy on the Naga, it is so easy to kite Havoc's BKB now. You saw him pop it there. It got him absolutely nothing. He's now down to 7 seconds and won't have it available for this push, so without it, he can do nothing. The blind chance of the Naga burn is a little too much.
This is looking spooky here for Team Spirit. Again, we want to emphasize that this is a best of three. So if Team Spirit drop this game, they're not completely out of the open qualifiers. They've got one game left to redeem themselves, but man, they're going to have to make a hell of a showing here. Team Secret, they're looking pretty strong right now. They had kind of a shaky early game, but again, with a Naga, you kind of expect that. And now she's really started to hit her stride. Yeah, I mean, this was Team Secret's plan from the get-go. We just always got a fear when they start dropping behind, man.
Yeah, you sacrifice Eternal Envy a couple times. He's died 5 times, but you do not care if Arteezy continues to farm. That's exactly according to plan. And I mean, the joke is that Arteezy's the feeder, but this time it's Eternal Envy taking that title on and doing it for the good of the team. He's got his Ags online now too, so a lot harder to bring him down if you don't control him with stuns.
I mean, he's still positive KDA. He's not just like feeding his life away over and over.
He's playing his hero properly. It's fine.
Yeah, I mean, he's going in, and we talked about in draft how freaking squishy he is. He always needs Arteezy there to bail him out. So when he's not there, he will end up going down, but as long as he can make some work of it before he goes down, even just dropping that cute little nether ward is going to be enough of an impact for the rest of the fight.
Yeah, and so far we've only seen the song save from Arteezy miss once. There's been multiple occasions where Envy's been gone on and the song is immediately there to save him. Arteezy has been on point. And as a result, the risky Eternal Envy Pugna pick is not actually that risky. If they can disengage when he gets gone on, it's actually a fairly safe pick. And now he's got a Lotus Orb to be put on him by Puppy. No, actually not Puppy. Who's got that? Pies. Did I miss C? I
think you're seeing some shit, man.
Oh, okay.
Crush in. There's going to be Eternal Envy in some trouble. Immediate song popped out from Arteezy, but PKB is cut right through it. There's going to be a shout. They look to turn this. Elf Ghost is getting slapped down. Another great ward by Pylai. Dai Havos getting low. He's going to get swapped out by his bench, but may still fall as well. Havos, he's down. He's got no buyback. And GG is called for game number one. Team Secret, they're looking good here against Team Spirit. It's going to be game one going the way of the Radiant. Yeah. Oh god, what are you hoping we see for game number two? This is getting intense, man.
Well, who knows? I mean, we saw Pugna Naga for the first time, so they could pull out anything. And I have to say, the lineup of Secret was actually so good for controlling Team Spirit this game. You saw the BK.